Hello students, today we are going to discuss the new poem Trees, which is written by Shirley Boyer. Shirley Boyer is the author of the poem Trees. In this poem, the author talks about the uses of trees. In so many ways, trees actually help the other living things. Okay. For example, it helps the birds to make their nest, and also it helps the children to play, and also it helps to make houses. Okay, in the likewise, the trees are helping in many ways to the other things. Let us read the poem to understand what are the things has been discussed by the poet in this poem. Let us read and understand. Okay, take a few minutes to tell one another the name of trees that you know. Just you try to know yourself, that what are the trees that you know. Okay, just list out, and then what are the benefits of the each one of the trees that you know. You just make a list. Or have heard of, mention the things that trees give us. Mention the things trees give us. Then read this poem about tree. Okay. So before we have to read this poem, you just try to understand, try to share what are the things, what are the trees that you know, and also that the trees that you heard of. And the next thing, you just discuss about the uses of those trees which already you have known. After that, we have to move on to the text of the poem. Let us see. Trees are for birds. Trees are for children. Okay, trees are for birds, which means trees are being used by the birds to make their nest and to play with their kids. Okay, their small ones. Trees are for birds. Trees are for children. Children used to play with and around the trees. Okay, trees are for children. Trees are to make tree houses in. Trees are to swings on. Trees are for the wind to blow through. Okay, if there is no trees, wind won't be blowing that much. Okay, so trees are for the wind to blow through. Trees are to hide behind in, hide and seek. Okay, the game hide and seek can be played. Okay, when you have the trees. Trees are to have tea parties under. Okay, in evening times, if you want to have a party, tea party, you can sit under the tree and you can share the tea party. Okay, there are. Trees are to have tea parties under. Trees are for kites to get caught in. Okay, when you fly kites, it may get caught in the trees. Okay, so here in this way also, the trees are being indulged, involved. Okay, trees are for kites to get caught in. Trees are to make cool shade in summer. Okay, during summer, trees are to make cool shade in summer. Okay, in summertime, trees give us the cool shade. Okay, trees are to make no shade in winter. Trees are for apples to grow on and pears. Trees are to chop down on called timber. Okay, if you chop down the tree, it would be called as a timber. The timber can be used to make houses. Okay, house. Trees make mothers say, "What a lovely picture to paint." Trees make fathers say, "What a lot of leaves to rack this fall." Okay. This poem is written by Shirley Boyer, and in this poem he talks about the uses of the trees. Okay, so again let me to read the poem. Trees are birds. Trees are for birds. Trees are for children. Trees are to make tree houses in. Trees are to swings on. Trees are for the wind to blow through. Trees are to hide behind in hide and seek. Trees are to have tea parties under. Trees are for kites to get caught in. Trees are to make cool shade in summer. Trees are to make no shade in winter. Trees are for apples to grow on and pears. Trees are to chop down and call timber. Trees make mothers say, "What a lovely picture to paint." Okay, if a tree can be seen by your mother, she would say, "What a lovely picture to paint." Okay, this picture can be drawn. Okay, it would be so lovely. Trees make father say, "What a lot of leaves to rack this fall." Written by the poet Shirley Boyer. Okay, thank you.